The Sahara Desert is by far the largest hot desert in the world. I say hot desert because by definition, Antarctica and the Arctic are also classed as deserts. But if we're talking deserts in the classic sense, then the Sahara outshines all other hot deserts by a considerable amount. It has an area of approximately 9,200,000 square kilometers, or 3,552,000 square miles, which is only 200,000 square miles smaller than the entire United States. It is bordered by three seas, the Red Sea to the east, the Mediterranean to the north, and the Atlantic to the west. It comprises much of North Africa, and its countries include Algeria, Chad, Egypt, Libya, Mali, Mauritania, Morocco, Niger, Sudan, and Tunisia. But this area, which is so vast and too hot to support much human life at its most barren points, has a rich and surprising history beneath its sandy depths, and signs of past life that has on occasion exposed itself to the modern world. We begin not in one of the most barren regions, but on the edge of the Sahara, in southern Tunisia, where in 2014 the remains of an extinct species of crocodile was discovered. A crocodile that was twice the size of the largest known crocodile today. Its speculated weight was 6,600 pounds, or 472 stone, and it measured 32 feet, or 9.7 meters in length. The terrain in the area at the time of the croc's life is thought to have been a lagoon facing the ocean, which would have been perfect for the sea-dwelling creature. Being a sea crocodile, the snout was longer and narrower than today's crocs, allowing it to glide through the Mediterranean Sea with ease, and being as large as it was, would have been at the top of the food chain in the area. The skull alone is a massive 5 foot in length, and the paleontologist Frederick Fanti of the National Geographic, who made the discovery, stated that the head was as big as himself. Originally thought to have died out in a mass extinction some 150 million years ago between the Jurassic and Cretaceous period, carbon dating tells us that this particular specimen lived around 120 million years ago, suggesting that the extinction was not as widespread as we first thought, meaning it was alive during the Jurassic period. However, the Machimosaurus Rex, as it is now known, is not the largest crocodile found in the Sahara region. Between 1946 and 1959, the remains of a crocodile named Sarcosuchus, or supercroc, were unearthed by French paleontologist Albert Félix de la Parente. And then between 1997 and 2000, six specimens of the same species were found by an expedition led by American paleontologist Paul Serino. One in particular, a 40-foot beast, was discovered almost intact. The Sarcosuchus species is thought to have been a freshwater-dwelling animal, unlike our Tunisian friend, and weighed a staggering 16,000 pounds, or 8 tons. Paleontologist Paul Serino is also at the heart of our next case. Well known for his discoveries of dinosaur remains, the American stumbled across remains of 10,000-year-old humans whilst looking for dinosaur fossils in the mid-2000s. Serino and his expedition team counted dozens of skeletons when the discovery was made in Niger in the Tenere region of the Sahara. But the answers to this newfound mystery would have to wait another 5 years to be answered, due to the civil unrest in the Mid-Sahara region. The burial site, now known as Gobero, was revisited by Serino's team in 2011, and it yielded more than 200 burial plots. Among the human remains was a man buried with his head inside a pot-like vessel. Another was found sitting in a turtle shell. A 10-year-old girl with a bracelet carved from hippo bone was found, along with the skeleton of a woman embracing two of her children. As well as weapons, pottery, and other self-made tools, animal remains were scattered throughout the burial site. These were water-dwelling creatures, such as turtles, fish, and hippos, meaning the Sahara was likely to be rich with water and plants during this time period. The human remains are now believed to be from two separate civilizations, the Kiphian and the Tenarian. They were thousands of years apart in time, yet the dead were practically buried side by side, only acres apart in space. The oldest of the two, the Kiphian civilization, lived in the region from approximately 8000 BC. Their skulls were much darker than the Tenarian people, with much larger eye sockets, and their bones were denser and more rigid. It's thought that they disappeared from the region after only 1,500 years. It's predicted that the Tenarian civilization didn't have their genesis until approximately 5,500 BC, a good 1,000 years after the Kiphian race died out. But they are said to have lasted 2,500 years, bringing the end of their era at around 3000 to 2500 BC, which is when the wet, green Sahara of old began to dry out in the desert that we know today. The desertification of the Sahara is thought to be the biggest climatic change since the Ice Age. In 2008, paleontologists Nizar Ibrahim from the University College of Dublin and Dr. Dave Martill from the University of Portsmouth, England, unearthed two new species of dinosaur beneath the Kemkem beds, southeast of Morocco, near the Algerian border. One was believed to be a pterosaur, or flying reptile, identified by a fragment of beak, and the other a sauropod, or long-necked, long-tailed dinosaur, which was identified by a 3-foot piece of bone, which indicated to the expedition members that the beast was 65 feet or 20 meters in length. Both dinosaurs were thought to be newfound species and were said to have roamed the Sahara some 100 million years ago. Ultimately though, it was the sauropod bone that was to make Ibrahim a well-known name in the world of paleontology. The 7-strong expedition, headed by Ibrahim, involved a 5,000-mile Land Rover trip through the Atlas Mountains. Heavy rain, mountains, and flooded rivers made the journey especially tricky, with a dinosaur bone too big for their method of transport. They even had to resort to a makeshift wooden stretcher to carry the gigantic bone down the mountain slopes. The huge sauropod remains were found to be that of the Spinosaurus. Ibrahim and his crew were not the first people to find remains of this creature. Back in 1915, fragments of bone had been found in Egypt by German paleontologist Ernst Stromer, but the few remains he had were lost or destroyed in World War II, meaning the remains that were found in the 2008 expedition are currently the only Spinosaurus remains the modern world have access to. The partial Spinosaurus remains were later used to recreate a full-life version of the creature. In 2014, the Spinosaurus was finally exhibited to the world by the National Geographic. Another layer of time hidden from the sands of the Sahara was brought to light in 2015 when a Japanese Earth observation satellite spotted the remnants of a large and ancient river in Mauritania, west of the Sahara. It appears to stretch 500 kilometers or just over 300 miles from the coast, and if it were functioning today, it would be the 12th largest river in the world. Its source appears to be in the Hoggar Mountains, also known as the Ahaggar Mountains, which are located in southern Algeria. Water is thought to have coursed through the river to the sea 5,000 years ago, around the same time the Kiphian civilization died out in Niger. It's thought that the ancient river once helped feed the capped Tamirius Canyon, a huge underwater canyon that extended off the coast of Mauritania into waters more than 3 kilometers deep. The next discovery takes us back to the year 1902, and it epitomizes the meaning of deep time. We as humans today only know the Egyptian desert as an arid landscape void of any signs of ocean life. Although we know, as our previous case tells us, that the Sahara was once host to great rivers, the thought that once upon a time, large parts of the Sahara Desert were in fact oceans as deep and as dark as the oceans we know today are almost inconceivable. But in 1902, 93 miles southwest of Cairo, a group of prehistoric whale skeletons was unearthed. Now a tourist attraction known as the Valley of Whales, or Wadi al-Hitan, it boasts a collection of fossilized ancient sea creatures, as well as the whales themselves, in a part of the Sahara that was once covered in deep ocean 15 million years in the past. The ancient ocean is known as the Tethys Sea, which occupied the space between Africa and Asia before the ocean receded and the land merged. The ancient whales are believed to be an extinct species, and are the earliest examples of whales ever to be found. The largest of the skeletons found at Wadi al-Hitan is 66 feet in length, or 21 meters. What's even more incredible about this find, and a fact that shines considerable light on the evolution of whales, is that these particular prehistoric whale remains had legs with toe bones intact. Despite the find being made in 1902, the area wasn't preserved as a tourist attraction until the 1980s, mainly due to the area being so difficult to access. That's all from me once again. Please subscribe if you like what I do, and I'll see you again soon.